that keeps writing English sounds require not one using it. Who was watching it also, what? Welcome. Hello everyone, happy new year! Woohoo! Wow, sorry, 2021. 2020 really went by so fast. I did lots of you studying Korean, love Korean drama, and there's a lot of you study Korean using Korean drama, right? So today, I'll be recommending Korean dramas that you can watch on Netflix, and at the same time, you can study Korean by watching it. Oh, also in this video, I will also include how you can use Netflix to study Korean, so keep watching till the end to know how to use it. Okay, let's get started. The first drama will be Hi Bye Mama.
먹고 죽은 귀신이 때깔도 굽다 그랬어.
난 귀신이다.
뭐야? 잡았어!
설마 나 지금 사람 됐어?
49일 안에 네가 원래 자리를 찾으면 영원히 그대로 살 수 있어.
유리가 살아 돌아왔어.
So Hi Bye Mama is a drama portraying the story of a ghost mother who died in a tragic accident while being pregnant with her daughter. From the day she died, she had been watching her daughter growing up next to her as a ghost mother. It's really sad even from the first episode. I actually cried a lot while watching this drama. There's gonna be comedy scene in this drama too, so you're not just gonna cry, you're gonna laugh a lot too. The reason why I cry a lot while watching this drama because like I imagine myself in her place. What if I was pregnant with my first baby and then I died before I even get to hold my own baby? So sad. The main actress, she can't even touch her daughter. Someday she was given a chance to be alive again. When she became alive again, she got to touch and hold her baby for the first time ever. So like when she was being given a chance to be alive again, at that time she don't know why the result suddenly can happen. There's a condition that she actually can stay alive as a human again, but if she succeeds in going back to her place as her daughter's mother and her husband's wife again, then she will be able to keep living as a human. She got 49 days to do that, but it's not easy as everyone already knew that she died, right? And especially because her husband is already remarried. Oh, also this drama is also very good for Korean learner because like there's a lot of scene like talking to children, because you know when you're talking to children and children when you're talking they don't use difficult vocabularies, right? I highly recommend this drama, especially when you feel like you want to watch something emotional and you feel like you want to cry at the same time you want to laugh. So I recommend this drama. Don't forget to watch Hi Bye Mama. The light in your eyes.
난 진짜 바다 건너 제주도 빼곤 안 살아본 곳이 없어. 매번 돈 사고 치는 아버지 때문에 하도 이사를 많이 다녀서 동네에 정을 붙인다는 게 무슨 말인지 몰랐어. 근데 정이 들었어, 이 동네는.
그래도 여기 봄 되면 꽤 괜찮아. 꽃도 많이 피고, 예뻐.
그럼 같이 보자. 봄, 같이 보자고.
So this is another drama that you gotta watch when you feel like you wanna cry and laugh at the same time. So then I'll be recommending this drama to you. Light in Your Eyes or Nuni Bushige tell the story of a young beautiful woman named Kim Hae-ja who dreams of becoming a reporter. While chilling around the beach, she suddenly gained the ability to control time, and one day she wakes up as a 70 years old grandma. When I was watching it, I was like, what? Is this even possible? How did this even happen in the first place? They didn't explain it in details. You really have to watch it till the end, because if you don't watch it till the end, you won't know the whole story. You will be confused. The storyline really got me hooked to keep watching it till the end. There's actually lessons that you can learn from this, like about family, about how you should do whatever you want while you're still young, because at once you get older, there's a lot of things that you can't do. It's very interesting drama, and so I put it into my recommendation list. Next, When the Camellia Blooms. The pronunciation is a bit difficult for me.
사람 마음이라는 게 3초 안에 어워치가 가능한 거구나. 동백이 처음 본 순간 3초 만에 깨달았습니다. 아, 저 황용식입니다. 황용식이. 이 저는 뭐 작전이니 밀당이니 어우 난 이런 거 모르겠고 그냥
언제부터 곳에 떠보고 싶냐고.
아니 그냥 첫눈에 반해버렸고요.
너 아빠 없는 게 뭐 그렇게 쉬쉬할 일이라고.
나도 아빠 없었어.
방 풀고.
엄마.
엄마.
저 미리 찰게요.
When the Camellia Blooms is a story about a single mother who moved to a fictional town of Ongsan and opened a bar named Camellia. Camellia is actually a name of flower, you know, right? I really love Camellia tea. 6 years later, meets a playful Yongsik who declares his love for her. He actually got rejected a few times, but the funny part is that he never gave up. Like, most people, when they got rejected, they give up right away, right? Because like, you feel embarrassing because like, you got rejected. Also, because like, in some society, the title of single mother is not so well accepted. And, you know, like, people keep looking down on single mother. In this drama, they show the struggles of a single mother. Oh, and in this drama, there is also a story about crime. It's interesting, it's not just romance all the way. I really highly recommend you to watch this. Oh, this one, Sweet Home.
Isan Jirjiri Shinata. Hajiman Kuka Sangon of the
Quinchanusia.
누가 이건데 가둔 걸 수도 있고요.
존경하는 국민 여러분, 현 시간으로 국가 비상 사태를 선언합니다.
저 감염자예요.
그 마지막까지 우리는 견디고 버틸 겁니다.
I bet everyone knew about this because so this Netflix original series is very popular nowadays. It was released last year with 10 episodes. It's actually based on webtoon. It is a really famous webtoon and they turned it into series on Netflix. Oh, before I start, there's a lot of blood, some gore, and even self-harm. This thing might be too much for some people and even written 18 years old and above. So I won't recommend this for people who can't really watch this kind of thing. So I won't recommend this, but like people who really love zombie drama, I highly recommend it. To be honest, the first episode is really scary for me. Actually, I never watched the trailer, so I thought it was a zombie drama. But actually, it's about monster creature. Like that. So, Sweet Home starts by focusing on the main character, who is a loner high school student named Cha Hyun-soo, who lost his family in a tragic accident. After the accident, Cha Hyun-soo moved to a new apartment called Green Home. Even before his family died, he already started having depression because of bullying at school. After the accident, he became more depressed and he decided to commit suicide in the building until strange incidents start occurring in his new apartment. Firstly, he witnesses one of his neighbors eating her own pet and turn into monster. As it turns out, his neighbor isn't the only one that turned into monster. Numerous people transform into monster of various forms. A mysterious phenomenon of human turning into monster occur all around the world. As people turn into monster, he and other residents trying to survive as they are trapped inside the building, surrounded by dangerous monster that about to eat them. This series nicely shows the best and the worst side of humanity while trying to survive. Each one of the characters in Sweet Home have their own stories. If you guys enjoy watching something scary, I highly recommend this to you guys. Next, The Uncanny Counters.
왜 나한테 말 안 했어?
혼자 마실까? 둘이 차 마시면 덜 아프냐? 네가 오늘 그 자식들 쥐를 밟은 거야. 이제 어쩔 거야?
네가 소문이야?
너 이상한 꿈 꿨지? 거기가 하늘나라야.
우리는 저승리를 하는 사람들이다. 너도 우리랑 팀이 돼서 일을 하게 될 거다.
앞에 한번 만나볼래?
몇 명의 인생이 하루아침에 바뀐 거야. 이게 바로 우리가 하는 일이다.
할게요. 카운터.
The Uncanny Counters or 경이로운 소문 is an adaptation of a popular webtoon, and this drama focusing on the character named Soman, who was a crippled high school student who is enlisted to be part of the counter to fight the evil spirits. There are noodle shop employees by day and demon hunters by night. Each one of the counters have their own special abilities and all of them have super strength that normal humans don't have. To be honest, this drama doesn't really have like a deep meaning to it, but it's an interesting genre for people who really enjoy Korean drama. You feel like you want to watch something other than romance genre, so like this is really good for you. It's a fantasy, it's like a like Korean version of Avengers. Like you're trying to save the world from villains, but like in this drama, you're trying to save the world from the evil spirit. Next one, Prison Playbook. Prison Playbooks revolving around the life of convicts behind the bars, their families and duty officers working in the correctional facilities. The main character was once a first-star baseball player but then convicted of assault after he saved his sister from a sexual attack. Actually, it's a self-defense but he ended up into prison. What I love about this drama is that each character, they have their own personalities and their own story on why they end up inside prison. In the drama, the main actor, the baseball player, he hurt his wrist, I think, but then he never gave up, keep trying practicing inside the prison. Something that you can learn that you should never give up on your dream. If you keep on working hard, keep going, you will be able to get what you want. There's a lot of comedy scenes in this drama, so I keep on laughing while watching this drama. Chicago Typewriter. One of my favorite drama all the time. This drama is actually about three resistance fighters in 1930s, which is during Japanese occupation of Korea, and all of them reincarnated, best-selling writer in Islam, a fan and a ghostwriter. To be honest, it's quite confusing at the beginning of the drama, back and forth from the present to the 1930s. So the main actor named Han Se-ju, a world-famous writer who falls into Islam and because of that, and also having serious case of writer's block. Writer's block is when the writer can't write anything. When the writer cannot write anything, we call it writer's block. No matter how hard they try, they won't be able to write anything good. The ideas just ran out like that. After the traumatizing incident happened to him, after he came into possession of a mysterious typewriter that somehow has tied to his past life. Soon afterwards, he met Jeon-seo and a mysterious typewriter, a mysterious ghostwriter, who also seemingly have a connection to his past life. Another thing that set the show apart from others was the fact that even though there were predictable moments, there were unpredictable moments all the way until the end. Chicago Typewriter is a hauntingly beautiful, well-made drama with well performance and great storytelling. The final one, The Sound of Your Heart. Son of Your Heart is about a story of a real life cartoonist and people around him, including his older brother, his parents, and his girlfriend. This drama really made me laugh so much. But then there's actually a lot of lessons that I actually learn from this drama. Like the main character, as mentioned before, he's a cartoonist, and as you may already know, there's a stereotype that people who work in our area won't be able to survive. However, like in this drama, you can see how hardworking he is. You can see from the beginning that his family is not only looking down on him because like you think that he won't be able to become successful with his work. But anyway, I really like this drama, so I put it into the recommendation list. Language Learning with Netflix is an extension that you can get from Google Chrome. It's so easy. The good thing about this extension is that it allows you to watch Netflix with two subtitles at once. They also provide translation for each word of the subtitle that you won't have to search it again in the dictionary later on. So all you have to do is search Language Learning with Netflix on Google and just download the extension. It's so easy. And then after that, just open your Netflix and search for any show that you want to watch and click it. Three study methods using the Language Learning with Netflix that I want to recommend it to you, which are dual subtitles method, single subtitles method, and also dictionary assistant and hidden subtitles method. First, for the dual subtitle method. So for this method, you can set your Netflix subtitle to Korean subtitle and also Language Learning with Netflix setting to make sure that there will be English translation as well. This is the best method that if you're just getting started with the Korean or you want to get used with this method of study, it is the best one. That's it for the first method. For single subtitle method. For a single subtitle method, it's not easy of course, because you won't be able to understand most of it. You won't be able to understand everything. But then it will be really helpful to train your listening skills and also your reading skills, because like, you have to read Korean subtitles while watching it, right? When using this method, I suggest not to keep pausing the video and keep searching for the definition. Instead of that, try to listen, try to pay attention to the drama or like movie you're watching, and at the same time try to understand what you can. But if there is any scene that you feel like you can't understand it, you still cannot understand it, you need to know what's the definition of this, what's the meaning of what they're saying, then I would suggest to rewatch that scene with the English subtitles together. And after that scene, turn off the English subtitles and keep watching with only Korean, dictionary assistant, and hidden English subtitles. The final method is still using the single subtitles method, which is Korean subtitle only. But this time, every single word that I don't understand from the subtitle, or this when I found a new word or grammar that I don't understand that is new to me, I make sure to write it down on my notebook so I forget about it and so I can study later on again. Also, another way of using this method is by using the auto pause setting. When you finish speaking, the Netflix will pause it for you so you can have time to process what they're saying, or you can repeat what they said to practice your pronunciation. This is like a shadowing method. Learning Korean by watching dramas, especially on Netflix, is so enjoyable. It's really fun. I really love it. So, that's it for today's Korean drama recommendation list that is available in Netflix. If you would like for me to recommend more Netflix show that I like, or maybe like you watch any of this, don't forget to let me know in the comment sections below. And if you're learning Korean, don't forget to use the learning language with Netflix to study Korean. So thank you for watching till the end of the video, and don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoy my video, and don't forget to turn on the notification bell for my next video, and hope to see you guys in my next video. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.